I play a character named Void. She is a young, kind of wannabe super, if you will, or I guess budding superhero. She's kind of coming out of the woodwork, trying to figure out if it's a safe world to let people know who she is and what her powers are. And she's Elastigirl's biggest fan. It was easy for me to kind of get in the mindset of fangirling her because I'm such a fan of the film. So I was like, okay, how I was screaming and yelling when the offer letter came through is how I have to imagine her reacting to Elastigirl. Void is, you know, she's a young girl. She's trying to figure out who she is and own who she is. And for all the supers, it's been really scary. They've had to hide. And I love the social theme of how tough it is on a human when they have to hide who they are. And in a way, to have a community that says, you were born this way and you're perfect and you should be allowed to be the best version of yourself, I think is such a universal story that anybody can understand. It's what we all want for our friends, our family, our children, you know, the world, really. And when you get into the personal aspects of how that story plays out for our characters, for Void, she's nervous. You know, she's a powerful girl, but you see her first interaction with Elastigirl, and she can barely get it together because this is the one woman who she's had to look up to in her life who's made her feel hopeful and who's made her feel like maybe her powers are a gift and not a curse. Well, I think that's what makes The Incredibles so relatable, and I think it's why people will love watching Incredibles 2. Yeah, our family is a group of people who have superpowers, but they're just a family. They have to figure out how to navigate kids and their sleeping schedules and homework. And, you know, in Incredibles 2, Violet is really stepping into her own as a teenager and, like, likes boys and is sassing her parents a little bit and doesn't want their advice anymore. And, you know, every parent in the world knows what that feels like. You know, I watched it and was like, oh, I remember when I first told my dad I didn't need to hear it. It's universal stuff, and the entertainment comes from the superpowers, but the sort of theme that is really true for anybody who's ever been part of a family who's watching the movie, I think is why it feels so relatable to people. I just think that she makes Elastigirl so funny and smart, and she's strong, but she's also really tender and humorous, and she does feel very relatable, you know, and it is really cool in this film, since Elastigirl is the one stepping into the spotlight and becoming the face of this super movement, to see how she balances that, to see these themes that I hear so many women talking about being working moms and feeling guilt over not being home, but then wanting to fulfill their own sort of purpose and passion and also teach their kids that being driven is a good thing. And, you know, again, these are universal themes in families, and hers just happens to come because she's a superhero trying to figure out how to campaign for the global safety of supers. And it's really neat to watch. Well, it's Brad Bird directing again and writing and creating, and really we have him to thank for the entire Incredibles universe. And I think it's his perception of social themes that make these stories so good. You know, we talked about how in the first movie, you're dealing with this sort of midlife moment in a family. And one of the things that I love about it is watching what every adult who watches the film takes away from it, and realizing that the kids watching the film take away a whole different thing, and they're happening in the same movie, and everyone has something to relate to depending on what stage of life they're in. And everybody gets to enjoy it. That's not an easy task to achieve, making something that has a really multifaceted story. And he's done it again.